I own Ramon's Bakery with my husband, Brian Ferguson. And I was one of the original partners in the business back in 1981. Didn't have an idea what I was going to do. My degree was in wildlife management, which is nothing at all what I'm doing now.
I am the Eureka store manager for Los Bagels. I kind of started at the bottom. I've cleaned toilets. I've swept floors. I still do that on a daily basis.
I started Wildberries in 1994. I started as a courtesy clerk. At the time, it was called a box boy when I was 15. We have about 100 people working there now. We've sold hundreds of millions of dollars worth of groceries. And I never really thought it could happen just to a normal guy like me.
And I run Redwood Yogurt down the street there. I've had it 32 years. I noticed there was no frozen yogurt shop in Arcata, so I was looking for something to do, and I moved up here and opened Redwood Yogurt.
What I really love about the business is meeting the customers as well, and we do a lot of custom special order cakes, and sometimes it's really fun to work with somebody on a wedding cake or birthday cake and make it, you know, really extra special. And the compliments that we get afterwards, or, you know, how the cake tasted, it's really gratifying. That is really fun. You need to make sure that customer is going to come back. The happy customer is much more likely to come back, and the unsatisfied customer is more likely to tell their friends that they didn't have a good experience. And so you really want to keep everybody coming back in the door. We'd like to say the customer is always right, but it can be a big challenge as well. You do whatever you can, and sometimes you don't make any money on that particular transaction, but that's okay. If they're happy and they walk away with a smile on your face, that's, you did a good job.
You're dealing with thousands of people all every day. We get like 3,000 transactions a day, and it gives us an opportunity, when we take the opportunity, to actually touch down with somebody and get to serve them, to do something positive for them, and get to know them in a way, you know. And after a while, once you deal with certain people all the time, they become sort of your friends. So I really enjoy having this group of friends in the community. I feel like I know everybody.
It's a constant balance of what things cost and how much you can think you can sell it for.
Be aware of how much product, you know, you're making, and adjust that to how much you're going to sell, because you don't want to have stuff go bad, because food is really expensive, and your food costs, you have to really control those food costs.
Always need to make price adjustments. As minimum wage goes up, we'll need to raise our prices just a little bit.
We have a job to get done. It's going to take a certain amount of labor to get it done. We can only squeeze so much out of you. So we have to look at all the rest of the business and say, okay, well, what else can we do? Can we reduce our cost of goods? Can we manage our expenses? And what about the profit? We have to look at what other expenses can we manage so that we can accommodate that increase.
Things like that are challenging when you have a business, but you have to be able to adapt, and you have to be able to meet that challenge, you know, if you're going to operate a business.
Probably the most difficult thing in my experience has been hiring quality, reliable people. And there's a lot of times where you can look at a resume or an application or even do an interview face to face, and you think that the person that you're hiring is just going to rock it out and do such a great job, and they come for 2 days and never come back. If I get a phone call that someone wants to know if I'm hiring, I just picture you like sitting at home in front of a video game or something, not giving the effort to come in. If you are coming in, however, which is awesome, to ask if they're hiring, to bring a resume, to do that kind of stuff, absolutely look your best.
It's about who you are, okay, and how you present yourself, and whether or not you have confidence in your presentation. If you really seem like you want to work, that helps.
A smile goes a long way. If you're on the front end, a smile is like key.
My favorite thing about being in food service is all of the opportunities that it opens up. I have never worked in a food service job that didn't have an opportunity to move up. They're, you know, from McDonald's to working at Los Bagels or Panera Bread or any of these places that I've been, there has always been some sort of opportunity from where I was hired. There's always that next step.
Don't be afraid to start at the bottom. That's where you will start most likely. And if you really want to take advantage of the opportunity and you put what you have into your efforts, that will give you the road, the path to move ahead.
It's the hard work, and sense of urgency is big when you have a food business. You can't take 2 hours to make one cake.
People that succeed are the ones who are willing to say, I'll do it. Let me do it. What else can I do? And those people, when we hire people, I always told them, whatever you want to be is up to you in this company. If you want to be the president of this company, you can do that. It's up to you. And it really, I believe that to be totally true. It's up to you how far you're going to go, and no matter what you do.